Good afternoon to everybody. I would like to welcome you on our additional part of our Sub-10 Summer University. Today lesson is related to realistic planning and PTP link using repeated, how far and how fast you can use our links. If you have any question, you have option to write it in the question window, or later on or at the end of the presentation I will open the question and answer session. Its introduction is just for remark what was the reason to make this topic or this webinar. It's really important to understand what are possibilities of our products, how to position the products towards customer to avoid that you are proposing the link with wrong parameters, with wrong capacity or not so good reach as customer is expected. Before I start with our main topic, very quickly about Sub-10 Systems. We are a privately held company located in Newton Abbot, which is the south part of the UK. Our main focus is to develop and sell millimeter wave product. These products are working on 60, 70 and 80 gigahertz frequencies. We started in middle of 2011 when we overtaken the solution from Switzerland company Huber & Suhner, and from this time we fully concentrate on develop and extend the features of this product. During our sales activities we found that it's important to have also additional products, not only millimeter wave, and this is the reason why we started cooperation with company called Repeated. Couple of words about Repeated. Repeated is company located in Stockholm in Sweden. They are fully oriented on 2, 4 and now mainly on 5 gigahertz product. They are more than 12 years on the market, and the products produced by Repeated are deployed from Arctic to desert condition. They are really worldwide deployed. Characteristic, it's carrier grade systems. It means the production, testing, feature development, it's really professional. It's not like putting some boxes or components together. They are already developed their own software. They are testing like traditional microwave system, so temperature going from minus 40 to plus 50, doing the performance test to be sure that products leaving company are really ready for customer. And also the, for example, PTP links are paired together, that if customer will open the box and start with signal radiation and the link or units are aligned properly, you will immediately have link up and you can transmit user data. What are highlights of this PTP solution? As I mentioned before, it's 5 gigahertz solution. It's today used not only in some dense city areas, but it's also suitable for rural area because we can go a lot of kilometers in some good conditions. It's also ready for fast deployment. You see on the picture complete unit. It's a unit with electronics, radio card and antenna. You can just install this one unit and make cable somewhere to the building and connect PoE. We are using standard PoE. It's not complicated. You can even use the switch's PoE capability to power this PTP systems. We are providing very high bandwidth. If you look for use traffic which you are measured on Ethernet ports of the equipment, you can achieve more than 100 megabits link. Our maximum aggregate capacity is 190 megabits, which is roughly 100 full duplex bidirectional transmission. Very low latency. Our latency is less than 2 milliseconds, which is round trip latency going from one unit to opposite unit and back, which is very good if you are deploying system for voice over IP for some video services. And regarding security, it's really secured system. We are, as first, it's not security, it's more or less benefits for configuration that we are fully supporting VLANs. And we have also inbuilt IS encryption. It's not possible to switch it off. The IS encryption is always on your user data are always encrypted. What I need or what you need for link calculation, it's very easy. You need to know locations. It means two places where link will be installed. It's very useful to know height for installation, what will be position of unit and where is possibility to install the power injector. Be careful, this link for gigabit system, it's limited to up to 100 meters. If you have, for example, 120 meter mast, you will not be able to install the unit on the top. You have to be careful that there are some limit coming from gigabit Ethernet limitation. And it's also important to know type of mast. If it's not topic for this presentation, but if you have not so stable mast and you have a lot of vibration and swinging during the wind condition, it is affecting your link. It's usually not affecting or breaking link down, but it can affect the throughput, user throughput, because system it's in this case decreasing modulation and skipping between modulations a lot of, and in this case your jitter or wander it's increasing. And of course always is the best to have some photo documentation before you install the link to be sure that there is no obvious obstacles like bad roof or not so good pole or mast for installation. When you have coordinates, you have to verify type of link. Keep in mind that main applications are so-called line of sight, that you have to have direct visibility. Fresnel zone has to be clear to be sure that you achieve what you expect. Another type of link, it's near line of sight and non-line of sight. For these applications, we cannot say it will work or it will not work. It's always a topic for testing. Our experience is that near line of sight, when you have some patch obstacles in Fresnel zone, it's working. For non-line of sight, it's really important to check it and test it before deployment, because if you are, for example, deploying links around one hill, it's definitely not working because there is no way for reflection. If it's in city, you can use some buildings or some areas for reflections and you will receive some signal. Be careful in near line of sight and non-line of sight, the throughput it's going down for non-line of sight dramatically, for near line of sight it's question, and there is no planning tool how to check what will be your expected throughput if you have near line of sight application. And last, what you have to check, it's regulatories or regulatory recommendation. Typical requirements which are country specific, it's maximum output power which is allowed from radio or from antenna. Whether you have to work in DFS, it means that you have to check for radars, and in case that there is radars, you have to skip from the channel. And also you have to check what is allowed channel size. Our system is fully configurable for channel size 5, 10, 20 and 40 megahertz. But again, in some counties, for example, in upper 5, 8 gigahertz, it's not allowed to use 40 megahertz. And to have everything correct, you have to follow these requirements to avoid situation that your link is against general permission or general recommendations. What is affecting the link? Not only whether the link will be up or down, and also what is affecting the throughput. First parameter is free space loss. It's logical, if you have short link, your stability and throughput will be higher than on longer link. And what is good, there is one simple formula how to calculate what will be your free space loss. Rain, fog, snow and this type of, we can say, weather conditions, it's not affecting the link so much. It's more critical for links with using frequency 6 giga and higher. Oxygen, atmosphere, absorption, again, it's not case, it's here because we are millimeter wave company, and this is very key parameter for us in millimeter wave, but for 5 gigahertz, don't worry about oxygen or atmosphere. Interferences, yes, keep in mind, this is unlicensed band, and everybody who is following the regulatory requirements can deploy the system even next to you, even 1, 2, 3 meters next to you, and you have to always check what is your situation in your location, what are level of interferences. I think this is the most important to know, interferences or channel, available channels before you start with some deployment, because it is doing basic decision what will be capacity. In many cities, mainly cities where you have a lot of 11N systems, we have experienced that it's very difficult to find 40 megahertz channel which is free of or good for deployment. Typically what you can see that you have 20 megahertz channel which is okay, and next 20 megahertz channel, it's affecting by some system. You have to be very careful, and practical experience are also that if you are not able to find 40 megahertz channel, it's better to stay on 20 megahertz to have more stable configuration. In this case, the capacity will be lower, but you will have stable link, and you know that okay, my link will work permanently on, I don't know, 50 megabits instead 100 megabits. And of course, type of application, if it's line of sight, it's working, you don't need to be worried. Near line of sight, non line of sight, before you confirm to customer that you are ready to do link, I highly recommend to make a real test, real measurement. As I mentioned before, the equipment is very light, it's not so complicated for installation, and you can take one PTP link and simply temporarily install it for 1 to 3 hours and check what is the link performance. Free space lost, as I mentioned, it's simple formula. You have formula on the screen, and I also create some table to see that for us it's not so critical to know exact frequency. If you look for a 1 kilometer link, and if you calculate the free space loss for lower frequency, which is a little bit more than 5.1 gigahertz, you have and upper one, which is around 5.9, you see the difference is only 1.3 dB, and it's constant if you look for rest of the for 5 kilometer, 10 kilometers, 20, 30 kilometer links. You see the difference between lower and upper frequency, which you can use, it's just 1.3 dB. In this case, we don't need to take care about the frequency. Of course, if you are able to use 5.3, it's better than 5.8, but there is no significant difference between these frequencies. Now, we can start with some link planning, because normally how system is, real radio companies are working, that you have to make some link planning and then install the link. During installation, that verify that your calculated values are correct, and based on this you will know that your link is properly installed, properly aligned, and you can confirm to customer what is expected throughput of such link. To calculate this budget, it's very simply, it's you have to know what is the maximum output which is provided by your equipment, or which is coming from regulatory requirements. You have to know gain of transmit antenna, you have to know free space lost. Remember the previous slide, it's easy to calculate it. You have to know gain of receive antenna, you have to know what is sensitivity for your selected modulation, and you can also know what is the, or you have to specify some margin. Typical margin is around 6 dB. And this margin, it's compensate that you have some tolerance on TX and ERX part, and also the system is changing the parameters during the operational time. And to be sure that you're calculating link this year and you will have same link quality after 2-3 years, there is some margin coming to this calculation. We are typically using margin 6 dB, which is enough for the system. If you prefer to have more strict calculation, you can increase this margin as you want. And again, you have a table for different distances, 1, 5, 10, 20, 30 kilometers, and the columns names are full and ETSI. Full means that I am using the maximum transmit power which is allowed by system, and ETSI, I am following what is recommended in ETSI, which is valid for almost all European countries. The next table is for 20 MHz channel, what is the receiver sensitivity, and it's logical if you see that okay, my calculation, my link budget, it's on this level and receiving sensitivity it's lower, you know that your link will work on this modulation. You have this sensitivity for 20 MHz channel. We have also similar table for 40 MHz channel, and be careful that as you can see, for example, for highest modulation, when I'm speaking about 270 megabits, I am using just 20 dB output power. If you compare with VPSK, which is providing couple of megs only, transmit power is 26. It's normal on all microwave systems or radio systems. Lower modulation, it's working on higher power than higher modulations. Now we have calculation, and I know, for example, if I look for 10 kilometers and I'm looking for ETSI, what you can see that for highest modulation I have to have minus 70 dB receiver sensitivity, and my calculation on 10 kilometers is saying that in ETSI I will have minus 81. It means I will not be able to work on highest modulation. I have to check what is the next modulation which is close to my receiving level. And you have also be careful, because if I have now interferences, I am receiving noise, and this calculation, which is like clear environment, it's calculating the noise level around minus 90 dB. If you know that your noise level is, for example, minus 85, what you have to do? You have to increase the margin to be sure that you are out of the noise, that you have enough space between signal and noise, because you are not able to reduce this noise. The noise is coming from equipment installing around you, and you have to simply to be sure that your signal level, it's still on level which is ready for receiver to represent or to restore originally sent signal. If I just example to, if you look for the previous table, it's without interferences, it's just using 6 dB margin. And you see, for example, 10 kilometers link, it's just on the edge. If you put full power, it will work. If you put ETSI, it will not work, because you see, with full power I have minus 68 expected signal, with ETSI I have just minus 81, because there is a reduced 13 dB difference on output level. If I add now interferences, which is like additional 6 dB margin, you see that this 10 kilometer link will not work as well on full power, because I have minus 74, and if you look for the highest modulation, you see that the receiving level will be minus has to be minus 70 on or better. And now to have some idea what is the speed of the link, we are using two type of speed. One is called air speed or air capacity. And this number, it's really representing volume of data sending over radio between two units, between master and client. And you have this nice table to see what is maximum airspeed which you can achieve on modulations, on each modulation. The highest modulation on 20 MHz channel, you can see 64 QAM, it's called MCS15. And on this modulation you have airspeed 130 megabits. If you have 40 MHz channel, we have a little bit more than twice. If you are using standard guard interval between the frames, you can achieve up to 270 megabits between two radios. If you use short guard, that you are using shorter time or space between two frames, you can even go to the 300 megabits per second. This 300 megabits or 270 megabits, it's maximum airspeed which we can achieve. And again, this is radio transmission between two radio units. For user, if customers are asking what is the throughput of the link, it's more important user capacity. And user capacity is saying how many user data now measured not on over air but on between two Ethernet ports, what volume of data or what capacity user will receive. And now you have this table which is coming from our data sheets, but later on there will be more detailed two tables presenting what is user capacity compared to airspeed. But generally you see that, for example, with TDD Plus, which is our top system, using 40 MHz channel, you can go up to 5 kilometers. In this case, you can roughly say that up to 5 kilometers we are able to produce full duplex 100 or fast Ethernet link. Keep in mind all these parameters which are on the table are called aggregate. We are in TDD environment, time division duplex, when master and slave, they are sharing same frequency, and capacity is split by time. It's not two frequencies as on licensed microwave. And we are always using aggregate speed, sum of downlink and uplink together. Left table, it's on the Trinity 116, which is, how to say, lower capacity system. You can see that the maximum is 100 megabits aggregate, which is like 50 megabits full duplex link. With 3-to-3 system, you can go up to 290, which is almost 100 full duplex system. And now, this table can help you if you are going to calculate your throughput for your user. You have on the left side, it's calculated for frequency 5.9, but remember the slide before, difference between 1.9 and 1.5 is just 1.3 dB, which is usually nothing, because you have the margin and it can be always compensated in this margin. First column here, which is white, it's providing you airspeed capacity. You see the lowest one, it's 270 megabits. And then you have in green fields, you have what is expected user throughput, again, aggregate throughput, sum of downlink and uplink for this modulation. And the number or each column is related to kilometers. We have table for 1, 2, 3, 5, up to 10 kilometer by 1, instead of 1 kilometer, and then you have up to 30 kilometers instead of 5 kilometers. In this table, you can roughly calculate that, okay, I know that my system will work not on the highest modulation, but on the, for example, MCS13, which is representing or 12, to be sure that everybody understand correctly. I have, this is 15, 14, 13, 12. If my system will permanently running on MCS12, which is providing airspeed capacity 162 megabits, you can expect that user throughput on this modulation will be around 100 megabits or 110 megabits. It's like 50 megabits full duplex solution. And you can look that for up to a, let's say 10 kilometers, maybe 15 kilometers, it's still okay to use it. This table, it's flowing ETC, because you see I have, it's okay, it's flowing ETC because I have 23 dBi antenna, I have 23 TX power, but system is calculating that maximum power which is going from antenna, which is called IRP, it's limited to 30 dB. And in this case it's like antenna 23 and 6 dB it's transmit power. And we have this calculation for ETC environment. But important is that margin is just 6 dB, which is okay for clear environment with not so high level of interferences. If I look for system when I have higher level of interferences, and it's now it's very difficult to say exactly, you have to measure what is the interference level and look what's what airspeed is used by your system. But just one example, if you will have like permanently 10 dB noise on each channel, which will provide noise level around minus 80 or 75, you can see how your throughput it's limited if you are using just ETC. You see that you are not able to achieve this 100 megabits on 10 kilometers, but you can go up to 4 kilometers. This is ETC. This is now what you have to use if you are using regulatory settings. What are technical maximum of the equipment to have, how to say, strop or maximum what you can use or our system? It's this one, because you see difference, it's now the maximum limit, it's not 30 dB, which is ETC, it's 50 dB, which is okay for 23 antenna plus 23 radio, which is 46. And you see same calculation, but compare if I am going to first table, you see that I have, for example, for highest capacity, I am not able to go over 6 kilometers. If I am going to the maximum power, I am going from 6 kilometers to 10 kilometers. And again, this is for full capacity with in environment when you have very low level of interferences or noise level. If I add additional noise to the system, like 10 dB noise, you see what is the change. Now I am not going with full capacity to previous slide was like 10 kilometers. Now I am able to go to the 3 kilometers only. And now some real links. I put five links which we are running long time, and we have some statistical data. We know long time airspeed. These links are testing link. You see that they are using higher power than it's officially allowed by ETSI. You see distance. It's a lower system, which is Trinity 116. It's on distance 2.6 kilometers, and you see airspeed. And then you have four Trinity 323 links. All links are configured to use 40 megahertz channel, and there is one link which is index number 4 with limited maximum rate, that this system is not going to 270, it's just going from lowest modulation to up to 216, which is you see on the table. This is this row, this line. And so there is the second link in parallel, which is configured for full capacity. It means this link is able to go up to 270 megabits airspeed. Now you see the airspeed limits, and you have this table which I present on the previous slides, and you can check in this table what will be user throughput. Now on the link number 5, for example, I see that the average airspeed is something like 235 or 36, which is looking like between 216 and 243. Keep in mind, system is transmitting sometimes is higher frequency modulation, sometimes with lower modulation, and this is why you see a value which is not exactly in the table. You see average value for some long time if you are doing the management of the link. And now I can decide, okay, I am between MCS 13 and 14. In this case, my user throughput will be between 150 and 170 megabit. You cannot find exact figure like 163 megabits, because again, it's the noise, it's a variable during the time. And if you have higher noise, the system is using lower modulation. If you are using higher noise, if you have lower noise, system is using higher modulation. And this is why you have always something like range. But we can say that approximately throughput, aggregate throughput of such link will be 160 megabits. And when you have the link finished, what you have to do, or what is my suggestion to do before final channel selection, it's always important to make spectrum analyze. If you have installed our Trinity system, it's very useful too that you have inbuilt spectrum analyzer. You can make the spectrum measurement and to see what channels it's good for my system for transmission. Keep in mind, you have to do it on both sides, because one channel on master can be looking can be okay with almost no noise. On opposite side, where you are going install the client, can be another technology using same channel, and you will have a lot of noise on this channel. You have to always check master slave or master client and compare and find the channel which is the best for both. If you don't need really full capacity, but customer is asking, okay, I need stable connection and it's enough to have stable, I don't know, 20 megabits full duplex, which is like 40 megabits aggregate, think about the channel size. I mentioned we can provide or we can configure system to support 5, 10, 20 and 40 megahertz channel. Always check if you really need the highest one, because the 40 megahertz channel is more sensitive to interferences. If you know that 10 megahertz channel will be enough for capacity required by customer, simply configure link for 10 megahertz channel. Next step, verify received and calculated power level. You have slides before, there is the formula calculating how to calculate the free space loss, how to calculate link budget, and at the end of this link budget calculation, you have expected received level of the signal. Always compare that your receiving level, it's on same level. There is difference like, I don't know, 2, 3, maximum 5 dB between what you calculate and what you receive. If you have different value, there has to be many reasons for it. First, there can be issues alignment, that your link is not properly aligned, which is not so critical for 5 GHz, because antennas are using the wide or not so narrow beam as higher frequencies. But again, it can be a mistake during alignment. And second, it can be some issue with equipment. It can be something with card, it can be something with RF cable. It's very important if you are using the external antennas that people are not properly connect one end or there is some issue on the patch cord or RF cable between unit and antenna. And also there can be something wrong with antenna. And it's always important to check that you are receiving what you expect. On system, if you have running Trinity, you have very useful status page. And after installation, before the system is going to the real service, check the status page for some time to be sure that receiving level of the signal it's okay. You have no difference between both polarization and both channel if you are running 40 MHz configuration. Check the errors. System is providing what is the error during the transmission. It means there is physical error. In this case, the frames was received and system it's not able to restore what was original frame. And second, you have FCS errors. In this case, system received some data, but after checking of FCS, he found that there are the errors and that these data are not valid. In this case, system is retransmitting, but you have to be sure that these values are not so high. And you have also information about radar detection if you have DFS environment. If you check the link, everything is okay, receiving level, the expected airspeed, everything is okay. Last step is to run throughput test. And this is really nightmare for some customers, because customers are doing simplification, like, okay, you mentioned that your link is running on 200 megabits aggregate speed, and I will run FTP server on it and test if my FTP transmit or FTP download upload it's on 100 megabits or at least 50 megabits, which is half of capacity. And this is the very big mistake, because this to use FTP or any type of application like file transfer or so on, it's not testing fully the link. It's the final result of such tests, it's always related. What is your computer power? How many processors, frequencies, how many memory? What type of operating system are you using? If it's Windows XP with a lot of application, the system will be bad for such testing. And last thing, this final throughput is always relating on application. If you will test on PC and you have opened some additional application, I don't know, some picture editor or Excel, Word, the system is, you can see that FTP will be lower as well. And this is the main mistake, that they are using application which is not just related to capacity of the link, but also on computer, what is the status of the computer, resources on this one. Our suggestion is to use a regular tester tool, but before you go with such tool, you have inbuilt throughput test, which is directly in Trinity. You can simply test. The disadvantage of this tool today is that it's just unidirectional. That if you run this throughput test, system is testing for 5 seconds, which is the maximum capacity, but from one side. But you have at least some information that your user throughput is on expected level. The best scenario is to have regular tester tool, which are, you know, I don't know, company like VX or some X4, they are producing very expensive tools which are ready for measurement. But I understand for some links or some installation, it's probably not possible to have such expensive tool. The last option is to use iPerf. Just be careful what is the usage of iPerf, because to test the link, the best it's to use the iPerf with UDP option, not to use TCP, which is again application level. And also you have to be sure that your computer is generated what you expect. We have experienced that if you have very old Windows system and you run iPerf with parameter minus B 500 megs, which is parameter to saying, okay, generate 500 megabits data, the Windows systems are usually not able to do it. And there is another parameter which is called minus I, and you can specify time, and my suggestion to use minus I1, which is every second writing what this system doing. On client side, you will see what volume of data it's sending from the client, and on server, same parameter is providing you value what is receiving level. And you can now compare, and you will see what is really real super, because if you see, okay, my client is sending 200 megabits, and the opposite side it's receiving 150 megabits, you are sure that the link throughput is 150 megabits. But it can also happen that you specify, okay, send on client side 200 megabits, but if you check this output of the client, you will see that system is not generating 200, just 100 megabits. And you can see on opposite side that, for example, 99 megabits it's received. And first reaction of the customer is, okay, your link is not on throughput 150, it's just on 100. But it's not issue of the link, it's issue of iPerf, because you are not generating so big stream or so higher capacity as you require. Keep it in mind, because it's a very often mistake that people are using some Windows machine, and Windows are not able to generate this capacity which you expect or which you put as parameter. What you have on the Trinity or repeated PTP product, I made just two screenshots. One is from the tools, and in tools we have two tools. I mentioned Spectrum Analyzer. The Spectrum Analyzer is providing you what is the level of the interferences, what are other systems around you. And second, it's speed test. I mentioned it's inbuilt test. Just keep in mind it's running just for 5 seconds, and it's unidirectional. It's testing from one side to opposite side. What is the advantage of this testing utility? That you can see up to last 10 results. You see now that the system is holding 2 results, and if you are running the link next to up to reboot or power off, power on, the system is holding last 10 measurement of the speed of the throughput. The second screenshot is this extended status page, which I mentioned as well, and you have now full view of information which you have. Starting from the top, you have radio status. You have receiving strange signal indicator. You see it per each chain and per each module, per each channel and per each polarization. You see what channel is used. So there is number, which is channel 36, and you can also see frequency, which is 5.18 gigahertz. And then you have this parameter receiving level. It's minus 53, and you have noise level minus 94. This is our lap link. It's without interferences. It's I think top system, but usually you will have noise level higher than minus 94. The next parameter, it's TX rate. Now, this is what is the real airspeed. This is the speed used between a radio. Now you see it's 300 megabits because it's the highest one. If you configure 20 megahertz channel, you will see 130 only. But this is parameter which you have to check, whether it's really system running on airspeed which you expect. Then you have information about the connection on the Ethernet port. It's also useful to verify that it's in this case running as gigabit. Sometimes it can happen that system it's connected to the gigabit port, but the gigabit port is limited to the Ethernet only, and in this case you will not be able to achieve more than 20 megabits because you have limitation on Ethernet port. Then you have status about link uptime and system uptime. Link uptime is how long it's link up. Means live connection between two units, and system uptime it's how long it's system power on. If you switch it off now, it will be zero on both sides, but now if I break the link, I will see still that uptime of the system is 4 hours 41 minutes, but link uptime will be zero. Pardon. And bottom of the page, it's the statistic. You see receiving data as megabits or megabytes per second. You see what is the number of packets. You see, and these packets you see as Ethernet frames on wired part, and you see also the radio frames or radio packets, its number of frames sent over the radio. And then you see last 4 pages are, or 4 lines are related to the errors. If you see this axis retrace radio, and now it's 0 packets per second, it's a typical value because it's saying that system on 11N system you have number of retries, which is around 14 or 15 retries. And this number is increasing only if system is trying more than 14 times and still the transmission is unsuccessful. In this case, you will know that system is trying to retransmit some data, and if this number is higher than zero and it's going a couple of tens or even hundreds, it's definitely something wrong with the link. You have to probably check or select another channel. The next is checksum errors. This is what I mentioned. System is receiving data, but it's discovering that there is some FCS errors, some change between zeros and ones. Physical errors. This is number of frames which are going to the system, but system is not able to restore it as frames. It's something very bad during the transmission. And last one, it's radar physical errors. It's number of you can see number in case that you are DFS activated and the system is really detecting some DFS. Okay, this is all about this link planning. There is no simple answer how far and how fast, but now you have at least idea how to calculate it. You have to calculate what is the link distance, what will be used channel, what is allowed power, or you can officially you cannot use higher power than it's allowed. The reality is a little bit different, but keep in mind there are some regulatory requirements. You will calculate your expected receiving level, and based on the noise level in your exact location, you can use this two table which you have in this presentation, and then you can find between the tables what is the expected airspeed, and then you have additional table which are saying, okay, if I have this airspeed, what can be user throughput achievable on such link. We have additional information. You can join us on Facebook, LinkedIn or Twitter. We have also a lot of data, some like short videos on YouTube. If you look for Sub10 Media Group, you will find a lot of this useful videos, short and sometimes longer as well. And we have our support webpage where you know this support webpage because you use it for registration. Very soon this session will be posted on our support page, and if you need go back or if you would like to present it to some of your colleagues, you can simply go to the support page or YouTube and you will find a recorded video from this session. Okay, now it's time for questions. I don't see any question. I can try to unmute. Okay, I am just now unmuting your microphones. If there is, it will be probably noisy a little bit. If anybody has question, it's time to talk now. Any question? Okay. As usual, there is no question. I don't see any question in question window. In this case, thank you for your time. If you will have any question, you can contact me or somebody from our support team. And I thank you again for your time and wish you the nice rest of the day.